The Red Raven, because although it's a novel in a sense, isn't it? It's also terribly based on real things that have happened to you.
I wanted to call it I wanted to coin a new description, autobiographical addition to whatnot, but it doesn't work. It doesn't work. In America, they just put this aside and call it a novel.
Hmm. It's a novel about, which I won't be giving away anything, will I, by saying shall I? All right, a little bit about it so that they can go away and read it. But it's a novel about a girl who is in love, her first love, yes?
Here in England.
And with a man called Jerome.
That's right.
And she's very, very fond of a girlfriend called Annabelle.
One and only girlfriend.
Right. Yeah. I mean, terribly fond of her, in fact, isn't she? And Annabelle and Jerome are known to the heroine, are having a long, bitter, beautiful love affair.
Exactly, and it's so easy to cheat an actress who has a matinee and an evening performance.
Yes, which was you in the book.
Which was me in the book. And so I didn't know. I didn't know. Didn't want to know, perhaps. Anyway, I'm not going to give you the details of this rather convoluted and awful triangle. But I always felt I wanted to write it as a play or something because it was in many ways quite incredible, don't you think?
Yes, but is it true that you found her diary? She left you her diary.
Mm-hmm.
Now then, how could you bear to have read it when you knew that it would be containing things about yourself and the man you loved?
That's why I put it off for 10 years.
Mm.
I lugged it about with me and I knew it would contain the details of this affair. Now, it's usually the details that linger. The big thing, all right, you swallow somehow, but it's the details that you never forget. And I knew I was going to know the details. However, then, sitting for my portrait, I discovered a little sculpture. And the sculpture was the head of my girlfriend.
The girlfriend in the book.
In the book. So I thought, seeing it, looking at it while I was posing, looking at that profile by the hour, I thought, the time has come, the walrus said, for you to open that diary. And I did. That's the story.
Would you ever, having now read her diary, ever keep a diary of your own?
I do.
Are you not worried that somebody might read that diary sometime?
No, because it's not that. I'm not in agony. The girl Annabelle was in agony when she wrote and had to pour her vitriol, her bitterness, her hatreds and her love into the diary. I'm in none of emotional upheaval situations. Mm. When I write diaries, I write them only just now when I have interesting conversations. And I used to write a diary, let's say, when I went to visit Shaw. I wrote that down word for word at night.
Mm. But your diary, therefore, isn't about what you do so much as what you think and what other people say.
Yes, yes, absolutely.
Would you dare risk writing down what you do, Lilli?
Yes, yes, oh God, yes. I'm lucky, you see. I've been now for 24 years rather happily married, and so I'm a dull girl. I'm a girl without adventures. I showed my autobiography to a Hungarian very famous lady star who said some very funny words. She said, "Is interesting as book," she said, "but is not book of star because you do not have enough affairs."
This is your autobiography.
Yes. Yeah.
Now then, when you went for analysis once, though, you were told...
Oh, no, I didn't go to analysis.
What
I went to a psychiatrist
right.
for advice, that was all.
And
I
the
went
advice
twice.
Was, go out and sin, come back and repent.
How well you remember that.
I do remember that, which
remember
meant go out and have affairs.
And I did try to go out and sin just once. It lasted 24 years. I'm still there. Shows you.
Yeah. The possible sort of element of your book, which got me even more than anything else about it, was the business with the friend, right? Mm. The Annabelle character in the book.
My girlfriend, yeah.
Your girlfriend. Because you obviously were more hurt by her betrayal than by the man's.
Of course.
Why?
Well, even then, I was brainwashed in a possibly like every young woman is, to the fact that if you have an attractive man as a boyfriend, you might, if you're unlucky, you might be betrayed.
Mm.
But a girlfriend, you trust.
Mm.
And also, you know, relationships between men and women pass, even though you think it is a great love of your life. But friendships must never, never cease.
Mm.
Shaw said that, remember?
What?
Of Alan Terry.
Mm.
he said when they reproached him that he was so desperately fond of a woman who was married for three times, don't forget it was Victorian England. He said, ah, well, her marriages are adventurous, but her friendships are enduring. Mm.
You know, when you read Annabelle's diary, and she was talking about you, was that the part that hurt you most of all? I mean, at one time she called you a cow, I think.
Cow eyes, as you say.
Cow eyes.
Well, she, you must understand, is very interesting. As a woman, was exasperated by my antennas not working, that I didn't feel that there was something between her and the man I loved. This exasperated her. She would have felt it. Mm. But I am a late developer. And I understood that she was torn in so several directions. Her genuine love for me, her love, it was more than love, she was beholden to him, and her frustration that I didn't know, she couldn't tell me. I think she would have loved me to find out.
Do you think she was giving you hints? Because I had a feeling that was part of what it was all about, is that she wanted you to find out. She wanted to almost be stopped.
And on the other hand, she thought she was protecting me because she absorbed all his bad qualities on her person so as to leave him free to vent his love on me. Quite right. Mm.
You say that Jerome, right, mm-hmm. is alive still.
Oh, yeah.
The man.
Yes.
Now then, has he contacted you since he read that book?
Well, I gave him the manuscript to read before I delivered it to the publisher. I thought it was only fair that he should say okay, because after all, I write about his father, his mother, his love affair. And he spent a very unhappy night 2 years ago when the book came out in Germany at our house, and then came to breakfast in the morning looking as if he had cried. But he said okay. And he made great friends with my husband, and since when we've become friends again. It's strange, isn't it?
There's one thing that I read an article the other day by, I think her name is Mary Gordon, a novelist, and she said that she thought that since women's liberation, one thing that happened to women, which she treasures, is that they have now got more confidence in each other, women that is, right? That previously they would be frightened of another woman pinching their chap from them, for instance, that women would regard each other, that's a bitch, and be very, very wary. But women's liberation has made them confident in themselves, and therefore they expand with each other much more than they used to. Do you think this is true?
I think girlfriends go pinching the girlfriend's husband as much as ever. Mm. But what I think is that the betrayed woman doesn't take it in such desperately unhappy way anymore, because the betrayal itself nowadays is not so frightfully important. I believe that myself. I'd much rather my husband would betray me that way than he would betray me in another way.
Well, what other way could he betray me?
For instance, he could be lying to me about, I don't know, I mean, it would be unthinkable, my husband, but he could be betraying me about money. He could be betraying me by talking badly about me. That would be betrayal. But just a sexual betrayal, I think one could overcome.
Really? But I mean, that is still lying. He would not be telling you about it, would he?
Still, but I'd rather be betrayed that way. I'd rather he'd have a roll in the hay with somebody and forget and come home to me with all his love than betraying me in his character. This I would not forget.
But you were betrayed by Annabelle, and you found it was obviously terribly, terribly bitter for you to take that.
You're talking now of the woman, of the girlfriend.
Yes.
Ah.
But she betrayed you sexually, so did Jerome.
Yes. Mind you, I was 23 years old. I am no more, you'll be amazed to hear, 23 years old. I've learned a lot, and what used to disembowel me then doesn't disembowel me now. Mm. I have different values now. I would still not forgive a girlfriend, and every time I would forgive my husband. Mm. If I knew the man was worthwhile having in my life and being my friend all day long, I think that would be more important. Mm.
You said as well that acting is nothing like as important to you as writing and painting.
That's right.
Why?
It's becoming to be a bore, you know. I've done it for so many years and there's nothing new in it anymore, nothing that thrills me. And when I write or when I paint, I conquer new territory. I walk a very long way. And when I when I think I've done something fairly well, I'm thrilled.
It's not to do with the fact that acting can be rather transitory and painting and writing is there.
No.
And you've made a positive...
Don't think so. I don't think it's that. I think it's the actual act of creation that fascinates me. Also, one important thing, I am as good, bad or indifferent as I am. And nobody comes and says, oh, put a little more red there on that canvas, or cut all out all of those lines. And when you read a book, it's me, the way I wrote it. There's no cutter in between, no director, no fellow actor, you know, to ruin it.
So you're one person and nobody can bother you. Well, that's very
that's
nice,
right.
too.
Yes.
Thank you very much for talking to me today.
Thank
Lilli
you.
Palmer.
Thank you.
And